Hello everyone, today we are going to solve a recover binary search tree problem. In this problem, we are given a root of a BST and where all the values except two nodes are swapped by mistake. So recover the tree without changing its structure. So we are given a BST and we have to recover it. So as we know that in BST, all the left element of root are lesser than the root value and all the right element are greater. So in most of the cases of the BST problem, we do in-order traversal, and the reason behind that, because whenever we do in-order traversal of a BST, we find a sorted array. Yes. So let's start it using that concept only. So if I do in-order traversal of this, so what I will get? I will get 3, 2, 1. Okay. But as we know that in-order traversal of BST gives sorted array, so it should be 1, 2, 3. But right now it is this. This means we have to swap these two value. And our answer is this, no? We have to swap 3, 1. So how we are going to implement this? So we can implement this using one asterisk space. The first solution will be using an asterisk space. We can use a vector. Okay. So what we are going to do? First of all, we are going to do an in-order traversal and store it in a vector. Like this, let's assume it is a vector, and then we sort this vector. So what is the time complexity here? Time complexity goes to n log n. Now what we are going to do is we again start in order traversal. So when we do again in order traversal, what we find is, let's start in order traversal. So we do 1 3, so we reach 3. So this is our first node and I is our 0. Starting from here, we check from here, first element which is not matching, we swap that element. So here we are at 1 and here we are at 3, so they are not matching, so we are going to swap it and make it 1, make this as 1 and make this as 3. Okay, so now move to, you do not need to update this. Okay, actually you just need to update this. So this is 1. And now move I equals to 1 and we move to next element will be here. We are here. So as we are here, this is 2 and this is 2. No need to update. So last, at the last, we reach to this in order traversal and this is 3. So I is 2 right now. So we are going to update this. We are going to update this. So this will be 3 and this is 3. So we swap like this. So this is the first solution, but in the follow up 101% your interviewer will ask, try to solve it without an extra space. Without solution 2. Now we have to solve this problem without using an extra space. So in this problem, let's say we are starting with another in order traversal. Okay. So while doing in-order traversal, but we have to see ki is this a valid or not. Okay, so how do we check? We can take one variable, you can say previous initialize with null. Okay, we are taking previous and one is our root. Okay, one is our root. So if in-order traversal, previous always will be lesser than root. But if we find any pair where previous value is greater than root, that means it is a mistaken one. Okay, it is a wrong bit because it is not possible in BST in order traversal. And of course, our previous would not be null. Yeah. Okay, in this condition. So if we find any this condition, that means we have to check. We have to store that pair. Okay, so let's for storing pair, let's say I am storing first pair as first and second pair as second. So let me mark it as null, both of them in starting. Okay, so how we are going to do is, first of all, we start an in order traversal. So we go to 1 and then it's left, then 3 is left, there is no left, so we are here 3. So our previous is, we update our previous is, right now our previous is null. Okay, So we did not check any condition and we mark our previous as 3 and go to the right. So in right, when we go to our right, we see this is 2. Okay, and previous is 3. This is 2 and previous is 3. But the previous would be lesser than. So what we are going to do is we are going to take our first as 3. Previous, okay, we are storing this because this may be our answer. Maybe we have to swap 3 and 2. So we are storing first as 3 and second as, right now root is our 2, so we are storing it 2. Okay, yeah, so we move after this, we update our previous to 2 and go to 1. When we go to 1, our previous is 2 and this is 1. That means we have to, this is also wrong. So we have to change this for that purpose. We are not going to update first because this is already wrong. So what we are going to do, we are taking one condition if first is not null. Okay. So we are going to update this as 1. We are updating our second with the current root value. Okay, now traversal is over. So what we have to do finally is we have to update this. We have to swap this. So how we can swap this? Just swap by value. Make it 3 and make it 1. And your answer is here. I hope you understand, because if we change both value, so we can't change both value. We have to change only the second value. Okay, because first is already mistaken 1. And we are not sure about the second. We are storing it because it may be possible that it is, they are adjacent, or they are not, they may be not an adjacent. Okay, for that let's see the code and we are going to do a dry run with another example. Okay. Let's have a dry run here. Let's start with our previous. First of all, we mark our previous first and second as null. All of them are null. Now, our 25 is not null. So we are going to its left element and it's also not null. So we go to its left. Its left is null. So we go here and just check this condition. Previous right now is null. So we come out of this and update our previous as root. So let's update our previous as 20 and go to 36. So here our left is null, so that it's written 36. So let's move here. So our previous is not null, previous is 20 and previous value is not greater than. It is 20, it is 36, so it is not under this condition. Let's update our previous to 36 and move to its right side, which is also written null, written and nothing. So we, this is done. Okay, so let's left is done. So let's see our 25. So 25 previous is 36. This is like greater than, previous is greater than our root value. So we comes under this condition and we gonna update our previous first as 36 and our second as root value, which is right now 25. So we are going to update this. Now let's move ahead and our previous as, let's update our previous as root value, which is our 25, and then move here. So here our 22 is less than 25. So we are going to update our second. This time we are not updating this because this is wrong. Okay. And we are not sure about this. It may be 25. It may be 22. Let's say if it is 26. So we are not going to update this, but it is right now 22. So we are going to update this as 22 and let's go to its left, right. And right is 40 and 40 is greater than 22. So we are not going to update this. So our answer would be updating 36 and 22. So we have to update this to this and this to 22. And this is our BST. Okay. So let's discuss the time complexity. So the time complexity of this solution will be our O of N. We are going to each and every node of the BST and the space complexity. So the space complexity will be O of H for using an R recursion. So this will be our core stack space. But talking about an extra spaces, so we are not using any extra space, so implicit space complexity would be O of 1, but talking about the space complexity, it is still an OH, not O of 1. Okay, so yeah, this is the solution of this question. And if you have any doubt, so you can ping me in the comment section. You can check out the source code and the article in the description. Thanks for watching.